Let's see who is gonna win. I believe it's a Bug Stout Retro Revenant, and let the fight begin. Let's see who is gonna win. What's up everyone, this is AD Gaming and welcome back to my channel. So in today's video you're about to see an insane gameplay with the Fenrir, much bigger and much juicier than ever. I'm going to use the new Venom weapon. You see here two times the Venom weapon along with the Bane. So it's like the Bane, but it's the medium version of the Bane and the Toxin. And this is probably the best build for the, this is the strongest Fenrir you can run in the game, and you are going to see it in the gameplay. So without further talks, let's jump into the gameplay. Okay, so first gameplay we dropped on Moon Map, and I'm starting with the Fenrir. So first time ever this cryptic Fenrir, it really goes well, the Venom weapon and the Bane with the cryptic Fenrir. So stay tuned until the end of the video, this is gonna be epic guys. And if you haven't subscribed to the channel, make sure to subscribe to the channel. Also, click the bell icon so you won't miss any future content I'm releasing on this channel. Also, if you like the content, smash the like button. So what is that? It's a Orochi. We need to deal with the Orochi. So the thing is, you should not mess with this big juicy fan here. And this is exactly what he's doing. He's back off. Yeah, exactly what you should do. So you see here, I'm taking the beacon back, so I don't care that he took the beacon before. He just liberated right after. And there is a big juicy invader, which by the way, I'm also planning to release a video with the invader. So wait for it, this is gonna be an upcoming content. Like I said, there are so many stuff that I need to show you, and already I've done a couple of videos, for example with the Luchador, we took out the first skill, by the way. This is insane. So I'm standing in the beacon here. There are a lot of enemies and there is a shell. We don't care that this is it is a shell with a physical shield. We are going to destroy him really easily. So we even have a nuclear amplifier. We have extra damage. So this is crazy. We already took out two enemies. He's a Fafnir. So he has absorber shield, but luckily our friend just took him out. Phenomen just took him out. So it's really awesome what he just did. So what I was about to say, so I did a couple of videos with the Luchador, with the Sharanga Basilisk, with the corrupted Fafnir. So it's on my channel. Be sure to check them out, all these videos that I mentioned. And like I said, there is gonna be more crazy content, like I said. Oh, it's a Retro Revenant. This is gonna be interesting. So he's keep regenerating his health. Let's see who is gonna win the game. Win this engagement, I mean. So this fight. So I'm gonna destroy him. You see, triple kill. This is exactly what I'm talking about. And still I have more than 300,000 HP. And remember, we have the Bernadette Wolf pilot, which gives more HP. So I like to use, when I'm using the Fenrir, I like to use 2 heavy armor and 1 nuclear amplifier. In my opinion, last stand is not necessary. Necessary, I mean. Because with heavy armor, you have more HP and you have healing to compensate the loss of the last stand. You have healing. And I even use it, I'm using the Nebula drone, gives resistance. So, like I said, I built the strongest Fenrir in the game. This is the strongest Fenrir, and you can see it already. This is just the beginning. We are gonna play another gameplay, and we took out another enemy before. And I'm still alive. This is insane. We have more than 4 caps. There is a Ravana. We are gonna deal with him. So I'm activating here my orbital strike. I would like to get this kill. Come on, let's go. We gotta go, like, let's see if we're gonna get Living Legend on this gameplay. This is what I'm aiming for, of course. So I'm activating my other mode to get the speed. So, okay, this is a, what is that? It's a Revenant type. I think it's a Revenant, I'm not sure. So we are gonna kill him beyond godlike. Let's go. We are close to get the Living Legend. Let's see if we're gonna get it. I believe they're going to spawn the Titans. The match is going to over. We have more than four caps. Oh, they took another big one. So it's another big juicy fan here. And these weapons, remember that they have corrosion power. It means this is perfect to deal with other Fenriers and T-Falcons and even Titans. So this is why I'm telling you, this build is so versatile. You can counter so many robots in this game. And believe it or not, even Fafnirs. You see how I dealt with the Fafnir, this Fafnir and the other one. Even if they are in mid-air, sometimes you can take them out. And you can see how much damage I'm doing to this Titan. And it's a luchador. Pay attention, it's a luchador on the enemy side. So it's really rare to see on the enemy side luchadors. We got the living legend. Let's go. So the match is over. I have no words. That was an insane gameplay. The first one, and we will do another one, of course. You see, I survived until the end with the Fenrir, and we got a living legend. It was insane. Let's see how much damage we did. So, 3.5 million damage, 8 kills, 6 beacons. Definitely an insane run, and let's do another one. Okay, so second gameplay, we dropped on carrier map, and again, starting with the Fenrir. Another thing, guys, until we are gonna reach the center beacon, I have time to tell you about our Discord server. Where is it? The Discord server. There you go. Join the good business family and get news about everything regarding War Robots. Also, you can stay in touch, and there are so many cool stuff out there. Link in the description below. So let's deal with the enemies over here. We have some big situation over here. We have an Orochi, we have Retro Revenant. So this Orochi, I'm trying to get him, but he has the stealth. So we have here a Retro Revenant. Let's see who is gonna win. I believe it's a maxed out Retro Revenant, and let the fight begin. Let's see who is gonna win. So I have to win this engagement because we have to get the center beacon first. This is the key in order to win this game. In this particular game, of course. Always, if you're getting the beacon first, usually you are. It gives you a big advantage. So I triggered his last stand. Nice. Okay, so I have absorber chip. I'm protecting also the Orochi in the way. So look at that. It doesn't take any damage. Maybe it has resistance or something like that. With the microchips, we took him out. There is another. It's a shell. It's also, we just reach the maximum damage from the nuclear amplifier. There is a bulwark, I mean. We took him out, double kill. And there is another one, another enemy with Devastator, Orochi Devastator. It's gonna be devastating for us, but I believe we can deal with him. So, okay, come on. Drop the last stand, drop it. Come on, let's get him. That's the stealth, but we are gonna get him with corrosion power, let's go. I cannot believe. You see how many enemies they were attacking me, and still we survived all these enemies, and we are still alive. There is another Revenant. Are you kidding me? So many big juicy stuff that are coming towards us. So I have to stay over here. I don't want to risk myself and to go to the center because there is a June. It's okay. Let's deal with him. Come on. Deal with him. Let's go. We go a rampage. This is exactly what I'm talking about. So I have orbital strike. Let's use it. I'm using it. And I need to deal with this Revenant. Come on. So I have maximum damage from the nuclear amplifier. That's the thing. So I need to get this Revenant, but it's a strong Revenant. It has to be a well-leveled Revenant. You see how much damage I'm trying to do damage to him, but doesn't take so much damage. So we took out the leech and somebody else got the kill. It's okay. This is crazy what we are doing here with this Fenrir. This is it proves to you that this is, like I said at the beginning, and even before the gameplay, is he gonna be dead? We got him with corrosion power. So like I said, even before I started playing the gameplay, I told you that this is gonna be probably the best Fenrir you can run in the game. And this is a proof to you that this is the best Fenrir in the game, probably. Because we are still alive. The first gameplay, we survived until the end. And we are still alive. Despite the fact most of the enemies, they were attacking us. Including two big juicy Revenants and Orochis. And we even got the Titans. That was maybe an Aoming. I didn't even see him. I just was shooting him. We got another one. It was a leech with scourges. So it's a, it was a, what is that? It's a griffin? I'm not sure. I think it was a griffin. I don't know. I did not pay attention, but it's okay. It's a nightingale. Let's deal with him. Come on, come on, land. So I'm trying to get the Aojun. Meanwhile, I have orbital strike. And the thing is, you need to know also, it's very important to mention that I have suppression chips. One chip, of course. So it's really important. It's really helping. You see, every time I'm suppressing enemies, it gives me more time versus the enemies. When it's a kid, let's see if we're going to deal with the full kid. And I have a feeling that this is a strong, well-level kid. So you see how much damage I'm doing to him. So I need to get into cover. And then, again, I believe he's going to reload the weapons. He's using the machine guns. So he's reloading the weapons. He's trying to get me with the storm ability, but I'm trying to stay away from this thing. This is exactly what I'm doing here. Look how much damage I'm doing to him. This is insane. Oh my god. He has an audience. An audience that regenerating his health. So I would have taken him out if it wasn't for this Nordens, for sure, I'm telling you. So, it was a good run with the Fenrir. It's time to spawn the Luchador. And maybe some of you are asking, AD Gaming, is that right, this HP? It's a dream, it's more than 1.3 million HP. Yeah, it's true, guys. This is also, probably I will release a video about it. It's a Luchador with 4 plated armor. So I already released a Luchador video with 4 self-fix unit. You should check it out, top right corner of the screen. It's really important, guys, if you haven't seen this video. So the self-fix unit, it's you can mount it at the defense slot, like the plated armor, and also in the universal slot. So I need to get rid of this Nordens first of all, because this is the, we have to get rid of him, because there are a lot of titans in this gameplay, and we have to take out this Nordens. This is exactly what I'm doing. So I'm testing also the machine guns, and it's doing really well, the machine guns on the Luchador. So here we took out this Nordens, you see. Okay, I'm trying to get these Muromets. There are so many Muromets on this gameplay. So the match is gonna over because we have more than most of the beacons. Oh, he's using the ability. So yeah, definitely it was a demolition gameplay. Let me know what you think about probably the strongest Fenrir you can run in the game. In my opinion, undoubtedly, this is the strongest Fenrir in the game. Let me know what you think about it in the comments down below. 7 million damage, 10 kills, 2 beacons. Like I said, big and juicy. Let me know what you think in the comments down below. And until next time, have a good day/night.